lead is ubiquitous in the environment. It has both, as I mentioned, in some of these supplements, but it's also in a variety of other things, most famously, in the public's mind, in paint. Lead has some great properties, particularly if you want to use it for pigment, because it doesn't corrode. So if you want to have, if you want to paint your home and you don't want to have to paint it every 5 years, you can have something that has lead in it and that it'll stick around. The problem is lead sticks around and it doesn't go anywhere forever, right? It's an element that will be around. And it has caused a number of problems for centuries and is probably the first occupational toxin that was recorded, because of how it was used. So where is lead? It's in a variety of different things. This is a diagram of all different uses that it's been in. These are some of the herbal and home supplements that we've talked about, some different paint and so forth. This is probably the most common outdoor paint. In places that have been built, particularly before 1979, all the paint that was used was leaded. And so homes that were built prior to that all have lead paint. In general, most of that paint has never come off. It's just been painted over. And the same is true for the soil that's in and around that place. So if you live in a city that has majority of the homes being built before 1979, like this one, you have a pretty high lead burden in the city. And so it's something to be aware of if you are a family doctor or a pediatrician in the city, thinking about who would I want to screen for this lead exposure. Some other places that we'll see, we have some young girls soldering here, doing some jewelry making. We have people doing stained glass windows. This is a common one, particularly when people are about to have a child. They know they're going to have their child, and they want to get ready for it. And so they will start cleaning up the home. Maybe they'll do some demolition, all the while getting exposed to lead that was in the paint. This is an interesting New York Times article that was then followed by a study that looked at the lead content in urban chickens. It turns out that we know we have higher lead levels in the soil in urban areas, but not only for lead paint, but up until the 70s, lead was used in gasoline. And so there's that lead deposit and burden is still in urban centers. And so if you look at soil in urban areas versus soil from farm, we know it have higher lead. And so chickens will have higher lead levels.